Titus. I'm the executive vice president.
Cut his abuse of power a little short. For this young man. Wow. Just recently inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame the night before WrestleMania 28, and here he is with us tonight.
I'm not supposed to be here tonight. As a matter of fact, in a couple of days, I'm not even on contract here anymore. I came to talk to you. I could have done it privately, I could have, but it's gonna have much more effect out here because I did not come to talk to this John Cena. I don't even know who the hell this John Cena is. I came to talk to the John Cena, who is my greatest rival ever in this industry. I came to talk to the John Cena who when I slapped his dad, he walked into my hometown in Toronto in my match, a TLC match, and beat me for the WWE Championship by chucking me through two tables off a ladder. What the John Cena who beat the hell out of me and chucked me in the Long Island Sound. This is not that John Cena. I don't know where he went. I don't know if it was the loss to The Rock. I don't know if that was it. I know guys change after big losses. I get it. Andre after Hogan, Bret after the screw job. Hell, The Rock after he got beat by Brock Lesnar. It took him 8 years to find his mojo. But what you don't understand is that you can't lose. You have to find that John Cena. No, don't put your hands up in the air. You listen to me. You see, because with all of our differences, John, we're polar opposites. I get that, but there's one similarity that we always had, and that's how much we love this. More than anything else, all you and I wanted to do was this. From the time we were kids, this was it. Me in Toronto, you in West Newbury, Mass. This was it. You think this was it for Brock Lesnar? You think Brock Lesnar gives a damn about this? You think Brock Lesnar gives a damn about any of them? He only gives a damn about them if they can line his pockets. He left for 8 years while you and I carried the load. So I tell you what, John, you need to wake up. Because if you don't, it's a slap in the face to guys who love this industry like Shawn Michaels. It's a slap in the face to The Undertaker. It's a slap in the face to me. Wake up! I'm not asking you to beat Brock Lesnar. I'm telling you to.